Hello ladies and gentlemen, today we are going to discuss bisphosphonates. I am Dr. Muhammad Bilal and you are watching FRCS Orthopaedic and Trauma First Aid. Bisphosphonates are the class of drug that prevent bone mass loss and it functions by inhibiting the function of osteoclasts. What are osteoclasts? These are multinucleated joint cells derived from circulating monocytes. These are found on the surface of the bone and are situated in house-shaped lacunae and it functions by cutting the bone. Bisphosphonates are classified into two types depending upon their chemical composition. Number one is non-nitrogen containing. These are classical one and nitrogen containing. The non-nitrogen containing includes telodonate, clodonate and etidronate. The nitrogen containing bisphosphonates include alendronate, risedronate, pemidronate and zoledronate. Bisphosphonates drugs target the bone tissue. They accumulate in high concentration in the bone because they have high binding capacity to calcium and bisphosphonates are ingested by osteoclasts. The mechanism of two types of bisphosphonates is different. In nitrogen containing bisphosphonate, they basically inhibit osteoclast enzyme phrenesyl pyrophosphate synthase, which inhibits GTPase formation. Whereas non-nitrogen containing bisphosphonates induces premature apoptosis of the osteoclasts and they also form toxic ATP analog. Bisphosphonates are indicated in a wide variety of orthopedic condition as well as medical condition. Bisphosphonates are indicated in vertebral compression fracture. Usually these fractures occur in osteoporotic patients in which BMD score is usually less than 2.5 standard deviation. Bisphosphonates are also indicated in osteogenesis imperfecta in which IV pemidronate is administered and the outcome of bisphosphonates in osteogenesis imperfecta is that it reduces the bone pain and decreases the fracture incidence. Bisphosphonates are also indicated in non-vertebral fragility fracture because they reduces the risk of multiple fracture. Bisphosphonates are also indicated in avascular necrosis of head of femur in earlier stages because it prevents the collapse of the head. Bisphosphonates are also indicated in multiple myeloma because it reduces the incidence of skeletal events. The other indication of bisphosphonates are metastatic bone disease, Paget's disease, and polyostotic fibrous dysplasia. Bisphosphonates are contraindicated in the patients with a severe renal disease. So you must have renal function test done before the indicating the bisphosphonates. And these are also contraindicated following the lumbar fusion because it increases the incidence of non-union in lumbar fusion. So you must be familiar with the side effects of bisphosphonates. Commonly, jaw necrosis may occur in a patient using bisphosphonates. So in the history, you must ask about any dental procedure before starting the bisphosphonates. It may also result in atypical subtrochanteric femoral stress fracture and it increases the cortical thickness, so the picture of osteopetrosis may be presented in radiographs. That's all. Thank you for watching us.